friends and family, thank you so much for being here today. I speak on behalf of our class when I thank you, as we could not be here today without your love, generosity, sacrifice, and unwavering support. What is best in us, we owe to you. In total, we have over 900 students representing over 70 countries. We have been former bankers, consultants, engineers, doctors, lawyers, entrepreneurs, veterans, nonprofit workers, musicians, and athletes. Today, we stand together as one. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce you to the Wharton MBA Class of 2022. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now be joined by members of the Wharton community who have inspired and guided us inside and outside of the classroom. Today, I am honored to introduce our esteemed alumni and faculty. Please join me in welcoming them to our graduation ceremony.
Congratulations, class of 2022! Welcome to my Wharton faculty and staff colleagues whose support and guidance have made this day possible. Welcome to the friends and family and loved ones here to celebrate these soon-to-be graduates on their very many accomplishments. And a huge welcome to each of you, the Wharton MBA Class of 2022. In true Wharton fashion, today is a big day as we graduate the largest class of MBAs ever, more than 900 students. Yes. And I am thrilled that we can be here together to mark the occasion. Graduation marks the culmination of years of dedication, focus, and commitment. It is a moment when you might look back on all you've created, debated, analyzed, and accomplished, and feel ready to declare, I'm finished. And indeed, with this chapter, you are finished. But earning your MBA from Wharton also signals that you are prepared for what has only just begun. Most will agree that business school is a valuable preparation ground. The question is, preparation for what? Some will say it's preparation for lifelong career success. Others will say it's preparation for leading in a global marketplace. Still others will say it's preparation to flourish in our hyper-connected world. For the record, let me say that a Wharton MBA prepares you for all of these things. Rest assured, your academic experience has prepared you for what's next. But the Wharton MBA Class of 2022 is also uniquely prepared for
for what's possible. We cannot gather today without acknowledging the challenges and complications the world and all of you encountered during your time at Wharton. From the moment you started, the social, political, and global issues you faced were unparalleled. And while that means that you had obstacles to overcome, it also means you shared a distinct contextual backdrop for your Wharton experience that positioned you to achieve what no other class could even imagine. So as we celebrate you today, let me highlight some of the ways I've watched in admiration as you found purpose in what's possible. First, you learned the unknown. The Wharton MBA curriculum is lauded for its rigor and impact, but your class went far beyond any syllabi. You put the theory of thriving in ambiguity into practice in our ever-evolving environment. You not only navigated disruption, many of you chose to use it as inspiration to help others. In groups or individually, through clubs or on your own, you reached out to those thrust into tough situations and used your influence and ingenuity to help them navigate. Many of you raised funds for displaced groups, created online communities for people in isolation, and volunteered to help communities stay safe during the ever-changing threat of the pandemic. In short, you applied theory in meaningful ways, and you learned more than you know. You also lived the unfamiliar. Wharton's dynamic community means you undoubtedly encountered individuals from all walks of life. Such diversity enriches everything about your student experience and provides a range of perspectives that benefit you from the classroom to the boardroom. It also means that because of recent volatility in our world, it is possible that turmoil struck a classmate or friend whose identity or culture or lived experiences differ from your own. Despite not sharing their background, you walked alongside them, offering compassion and hope. You made their concerns your cares. Whether facilitating crucial conversations between cultural clubs, standing in solidarity with marginalized students after social upheaval, or simply making needed space for those struggling through trauma, you proved that support is a verb we all need to exercise more. Lastly, class of 2022, you led through the uncharted. Wharton MBAs are known for their leadership qualities. During your time here, you applied coursework, led clubs, and participated in a host of activities aimed at developing you into tomorrow's leaders. But what happens when a community needs its future leaders now? Well, your class took on that challenge with the intent to make an immediate difference. When racial tensions flared, you worked with peer schools to explore the topic of diversity in real time. And when the pandemic shuttered buildings threatening the livelihood of local performing arts, you mobilized to raise funds for their community. Time and again, you saw a need and filled the gap, even when the way forward wasn't clear and success wasn't certain. Yes, your class has learned, lived, and led in unprecedented ways, and now you are graduating into a future no one can predict. But after navigating your way through the unknown, the unfamiliar, and the uncharted, a little uncertainty should not worry you, because the solution for uncertainty is preparation. And Wharton MBA class of 2022, you are certainly prepared for it all. Congratulations and best wishes to each of you, and may you continue to thrive and have impact in the world. And I'll just add a little aside. I feel a special kinship with this group because we started together. So you are my class. As we continue, I have two exciting introductions for today's ceremony. First, in the interest of public safety and in an effort to have a little bit of fun, I'm introducing a slight alteration to today's roll call process. We are doing away with the traditional handshake, I know that's probably no surprise, as part of the diploma ceremony. But we're replacing it with three alternate greetings, of which my colleague, Eddie Crossan Banks, will be demonstrating along as I explain. When your name is called and you join me on stage, you can choose an elbow bump, a namaste, or a Wakanda. This is a small shift that will hopefully keep us safe and provide some extra energy to the day. All right, now for the second introduction, your graduation day speaker. It is my distinct pleasure to introduce Alex Gorsky, 1996 Wharton MBA alumnus and executive chairman of Johnson & Johnson. During his more than 30-year tenure, Alex advanced through positions of increasing responsibilities in sales, marketing, and management, culminating in him being named CEO and chairman in 2012, only the seventh leader at Johnson & Johnson to ever hold that distinction. Under his leadership, the company became an industry leader in areas including oncology, immunology, and digital surgery, and is now recognized as the world's largest and most diverse healthcare company. A supporter of veterans' issues and promoter of diverse and inclusive cultures, he's been a driving force behind the company's $100 million pledge to fight health inequities in the United States. Please join me in welcoming your speaker, Alex Gorsky.
Well, thank you very much, Dean James, for the honor of being able to ask to speak today, and really thank you to the class of 2022 for the very warm welcome. Now think about this for a minute. You did it. It's a big accomplishment, especially given the perspective of the last couple years. Now, I can actually remember being in your seat about 26 years ago, hoping that the speaker wasn't going to speak too long, waiting to get on with the rest of the family. But on one hand, I was really proud because I actually got through it and made it. But I've got to say, I was also pretty humble just thinking about all the graduates who had come before me to go on and do some pretty cool things around the world. You know, the parents and the loved ones in the audience, did you ever imagine that this day would come? Now, some of you may be Wharton legacies, and for some, this is your son or daughter. It's the first in your family to get an advanced degree. In either way, there is just no way that they could have done it without your love and your support all along the way. Now, I'd also really like to acknowledge the members of the faculty and the administration, without whom none of this would have been possible. I think we all realize it's been two truly extraordinary years, and they have just gone above and beyond to make your Wharton experience possible. So I want to encourage everyone to just pause for a moment and take it all in. And now let's give everyone in here another big round of applause. So I'll bet when you decided to pursue this degree, there was no way of knowing that the 2022 grads would end up being forever known as Wharton's COVID class. Now, what I would tell you is that I certainly would never have imagined that I'd be Johnson & Johnson's pandemic CEO, but guess what? Here we are. We're forever going to be tagged that way. But on a more serious note, I remember back in 2020, and I can still remember almost exactly where I was when I heard pneumonia outbreak in central China had claimed its first death. Things moved very quickly You know, by the first week in February, there would be about 10,000 confirmed COVID-19 infections in China, and then the first one in the United States. Now think back to what's happened. Today, the world has recorded over 500 million. Think about that for a moment. You guys are good at math. 500 million cases worldwide and a heartbreaking 6 million deaths around the world. I think we would all admit that in many ways, the world's never going to be the same for us. Now, in those early days, in fact, very early on, much due to some hardworking people who didn't really want to ask for permission, but really said that they'd rather beg for forgiveness, they made the call to devote Johnson & Johnson's considerable expertise to developing a vaccine. And what I can tell you 2 years on, that I have never, ever experienced such a rapid pace of scientific, engineering, political, and organizational challenges were just hitting me all at once. It was like drinking from a fire hose. The ambiguity, well, it came daily and took place alongside an unending barrage of scrutiny. And it was really at this same uncertain moment that you made the decision to enroll in Wharton. And you had no idea how radically different your MBA experience would be from every other class before you. And you did it all, facing fear and grief as the virus affected our families, friends, and colleagues. And it's fair to say that none of us had ever experienced anything quite like this. Now, I can only imagine the number of COVID analogies being made in commencement speeches on campuses everywhere around the country today. But I'm not here to talk so much about making the best of a bad situation, because there have been many lessons learned, and I must say that with each passing day, I actually become more optimistic about our future. And my source of hope for the future is really the degree to which business, and more importantly, each of you as business leaders, can be a preeminent force for good in our society. You know, one of the things I've always tried to be as a CEO and as a leader is what I call a realistic optimist. And to me, that means you got to confront challenges with clear eyes, but you've also got to create a vision and really a reason to believe in the future. And with this in mind, I believe that our imperfect system of global capitalism, it truly is the greatest engine of human prosperity that the world has ever known. And the business leaders, more and more, are increasingly stepping up to the plate to drive positive change on a global scale. I mean, consider how much has changed. Business leaders today, they're now accountable to a wide array of stakeholders. And it's really become a moral and financial imperative to ensure that purpose is infused across everything that we do in business. Now, I've had the unique privilege of working at J&J for more than 30 years. And it's a company that was shaped by our commitment to our credo, and it was a statement of corporate purpose that tells us that the greatest responsibility is to all the stakeholders that we serve. And that fair profit, well, it doesn't have to come at the cost of other obligations. And I think your past 2 years at Wharton gave you an accelerated view of just how foundational that concept of purpose really is. And as true natives to this new way of doing business, well, your biggest task is going to be twofold. First, continuously demonstrating that purpose and profit, that they're really not in opposition. And that business leaders, you can use your position to positively impact society and the world. And so look, I believe that there's a few lessons, however, that are really going to be foundational to navigating a radically new future of work and business that you're going to be entering to really help make the world and business a better place for all. Lesson number one, it's really about embracing technology, and it's the best way to stay relevant and drive change. Now, I can tell you, after just spending a week being out in California, visiting our digital robotics team, doing an Apple board meeting, that your knowledge, your embracing, your understanding of technology is likely going to be more important to your future than ever. And I know you spent a lot of time for the last few years learning IRR, NPV, WAC, and ROIC, but I submit that as important or maybe more important going forward is your ability to understand technology and innovation. Tools like cloud, edge, AI, ML, data science, or qubits. These things are going to fundamentally change so many aspects, not only of business, but of society. Now, please understand, I don't think you've learned all those lessons in finance in vain. But I do challenge you to consider how you're going to translate these skills into new ways of thinking, working, and executing in a hyper-digitalized world. Now, I've been fortunate to have led J&J during a decade long that it really accomplished pretty amazing advancements in human health, from unlocking the human genetic code, development of cell therapies, data sciences, drug discovery. We've also experienced a huge shift in the way we work. We innovate and advance digital technologies. So I really think it's a pretty fundamentally different world, and there's no going back. But the good news is the hard-won insights from this experience that you learned here at Wharton, I really think it can propel you to create even more innovation for everyone that you serve going forward. And none of that would have been possible without decades and billions of dollars of investment, research, trial and error, mistakes and failures and starts. And I think one of your other jobs as a business leader is making sure that you invest in the future in innovation in everything that you do, regardless of where you work. I truly believe, I think this offers our best chance to raise the living standard around the world. And we can better live in peace, address climate change, help people live longer, healthier, and happier lives. Simply put, I think we as business leaders have got to be a catalyst for change and innovation, provide those resources, and make sure that we're part of that job. Next, stay competitive, but collaboration and partnership are going to be a big shape of the future. I think all of us believe the competitive nature of capitalism, well, it's at the very core of its benefit to society, whether in families, in schools, in sports. All of us have been in some Darwinian struggle that made us dig deeper than we thought possible. And I've seen firsthand that sense, how that sense of innovation builds urgency and pride, and it can foster it within the industries and companies and teams. But I can also tell you, in no uncertain terms, that after being in healthcare for more than 30 years, the amount of collaboration that took place between academia, the government, NGOs, corporations, in response to the pandemic was truly unprecedented. And I'd like to believe that we could apply this going forward and work across other industries, whether it's biotech, fintech, education, the environment, infrastructure, transportation, or even just the way we live together. For us to truly tackle the world's most challenging issues, I think collaboration is going to be more important than ever. And we've got to remember that this collaboration has got to be done with diversity and inclusion at its very core. Because when you have diversity of people and perspectives, it's always going to propel you to a greater outcome. And as leaders, the task ahead for you is continuing widening that sense of boundless possibility and shared mission. Lesson number three, and this was a big one for me over the last 2.5 years, is that guess what? Stuff happens that you can't control. And you're going to need a lot of grit to survive and thrive. As you graduate and begin this next chapter, you should do so with clear, steely eyes about the environment ahead. And I can tell you from firsthand experience that the rate and pace and magnitude of dynamics and events outside of your control, I think they're going to only accelerate even more. From the various earliest days of the pandemic, we all had to operate in an environment of unpredictability and upheaval. Never had we seen a biological threat that so completely upended how we approached making decisions. When you consider it, they had enormous economic, societal, and public health consequences. It seemed like every time we had managed to predict something accurately, guess what? Something else happened and we got surprised. We faced twists and turns that eventually it became hard to be rattled by disappointment or be too excited about breakthroughs. I think in some ways, it turned out to be a good thing. This is Winston Churchill once said when asked how Britain was able to keep fighting in World War II while facing such a profound existential threat from Nazi Germany. His line was, well, you know what? Sometimes you just got to keep boogering on. And I would say, remember that. Grit and tenacity count for a lot in this world. And the pandemic reminded us that often things don't go as planned, that the spotlight's going to be on you, and at the exact moment when you're going to be under a lot of stress, and there will be times when the odds against you feel insurmountable, and when you know all it to be true, and you're still able to dig deep, rally your team, get the job done, well, there is no better feeling in the world. And I think each of you really had a chance to learn a lot of that early in your careers than most, and I hope that that gives you the confidence to tackle the unexpected in the years to come. So my last and final lesson is nothing, and I believe nothing, and this certainly we've learned over the last 2 years, is more important than good health. It's just so essential to who we are. Making up nearly 20% of our economy, 1 out of every 8 jobs, healthcare and public health policy, well, they're foundational to the world, for society, for families, and for individuals. Look, every business, political, academic, and organizational leader had to become a healthcare expert during the pandemic. Even if you never thought about incidence rates, PCR, antigen testing, infiltration, you had to learn it. We had to consider the health of our employees, customers we service, our communities, our very own families. In this moment, it also put a huge spotlight on the everyday bravery and heroism of essential workers, healthcare workers, nurses, teachers, parents, caregivers, and so many others. Now, I hope this interest and this empathy and care continues long after this crisis is over. And very importantly, as future business leaders, you need to consider the importance of managing your own health for your future career. So I'd encourage you to find those daily rituals regarding movement, energy, how you sleep, what you consume, how you relax, and the time and effort to take care of yourself so that ultimately you can make an impact and take care of others. Remember, the days are long, but the years are going to be short and go really fast. And making daily investments in your own health is going to pay big dividends for the future. So I have to say, I've got one final source of optimism for the future, and that is each one of you sitting out there in the audience today. As you go out into the world, you leave with powerful leadership acumen from the best business school in the world. But you also leave Wharton with critical and hard-won real-world lessons about thriving in an utterly transformed business landscape, and a new set of expectations for what businesses must accomplish to make the world a better place for all humankind. Now, I know the challenges ahead, they're going to be marked by a lot of uncertainty and ambiguity, but I have never, never been more confident in a generation of leaders, and I can't wait to see the incredible things you go on to accomplish. So lead with passion, lead with your values, lead with purpose. Godspeed and good luck.
Thank you, Alex, for your inspiring advice to our graduates. You are living proof how a Wharton MBA education prepares you to make a meaningful impact in the world. Now, I'm very excited to introduce our next speaker, your classmate and class of 2022 graduate, Carolina Weber. Raised in Nevada City, California, Carolina graduated from Harvard College and worked as a product manager at Capital One in Washington, D.C. Today, she is graduating from the MBA program where she majored in entrepreneurship and innovation. On campus, she served as a board member in the Tech Club, as a nonprofit board fellow, a communication fellow, and a student life fellow. While at Wharton, Carolina and 22 classmate Natalia Duarte founded their startup, Denari, a financial education platform connecting U.S. Hispanic consumers to reputable financial products. Post-Wharton, she will return to Washington, D.C. to work in product strategy at Google. Please join me in welcoming your class of 2022, student speaker, Carolina Weber.
Thank you. I stand here today with a deep sense of gratitude and humility that, by the grace of God, I can join all of you graduating from one of the oldest and the most prestigious MBA programs in the world. We did it! Take a moment to look around. We have so much to be thankful for, to be here in person. So please make eye contact with your loved ones, and I ask that you blow them a kiss or wave them a thank you. For me, my Thanksgiving goes to my incredible husband, Chris, my parents, my brother Ben, my sister Andrea, and my in-laws. Thank you for being here today. As we gather one last time together, I'd like to share two stories with you. The first is about my journey to Wharton, and the second is about our journey at Wharton. 2 years ago, I remember receiving the most joyous call in the world, the call that I'd been accepted to Wharton. As a grown woman, I was literally jumping up and down when I received the news from my admissions fellow. My joy came because I knew that this accomplishment wasn't just for me. It was redemption for my family's sacrifices. It was redemption for my dad's start here as a migrant farm worker, toiling in the fields in 110-degree humidity under the hot sun for 8 to 10 hours. It was redemption for my mom, who the moment she came to the U.S., she instantly gave back, volunteering to teach algebra at the local library while she herself was learning English. My mom instilled in me my love of learning. Coming to Wharton meant that not only would I be the first in my family to graduate from college, but the first in my family to graduate with a master's degree as well. And after 2 years among you, my classmates, I know that we all have our redemption stories. So when my jumping stopped, I let the news sink in. I felt both joy and grief, realizing that what was supposed to be one of our greatest accomplishments was shrouded with uncertainty, as I felt unsettled about what would our MBA look like in the thick of a pandemic. This brings me to our story at Wharton, where we took on the challenges of a fully virtual first year, and in year two, finally, getting to experience Wharton as it should be experienced, in person, on campus. In many ways, our time feels cut short. An understandable response to the situation would have been for our class to lose engagement, to lose motivation, but that is not what we did. These past 2 years, we woke up every single day of our MBA and chose thriving over languishing, determination over discouragement, perseverance over apathy. Our class will forever be like no other. And looking back, I'm most proud of us because we took care of each other. The text, "Did you make it home okay?" became our norm. We showed up for each other's big moments. Follies, dance studio, fight night, yeah, we crushed all their booking sites. And most importantly, we were brave, channeling our courage to uplift one another through storytellers, Real Talk dinners, ventures, you name it. I am in awe of your bravery and your vulnerability. Now, like any good Wharton communication speaker, I can't finish this message without offering up a call to action. A friend once told me that even if you were to meet one new person in the class of 2022 every single day of our MBA, you would still never get to meet everyone. And given that our first year was virtual, we're leaving Wharton with still so many opportunities to meet the rest of our classmates. So, this is what I ask of you. Given everything we've been through together, let's keep supporting one another. Let's make sure that in the years ahead, we don't languish, but continue thriving. I ask that if you see an email with the subject line WG22, that you be willing to answer the call to be there, to lift each other up, because we've made the most of our 2 years in Philadelphia together. Thank you, each and every single one of you. Congratulations, we did it. I would now like to invite President of the 2022 Wharton Graduate Association, Phil Ross, to the podium.
Thank you, Carolina. An awesome speech. There's a few more people than my bar mitzvah, so we'll see how this goes. So hello, everyone. I've heard I don't mention this enough, so I'm the president of the WGA. I would like to quickly thank Dean James, Dean Mary Ellen, Dean Howie, and the Office of Student Life, including Nadia Sharif, who put all of graduation together. I also want to give a quick shout out to the entire WGA board, and in particular, my fellow exec board members, Michelle, Issa, and Andrew. Students are the fabric of this school, and you all absolutely crushed it this year. Now, for the class of 2022, I've seen you on Instagram. I have seen you with your posts saying hashtag last day of school. And I want you to know, that's a little cliche. But while it is cliche, it got me thinking about our first day of school. Not at Wharton, but in kindergarten. I want you to think back to that day when you had to go into a strange building, maybe you were proudly strutting in with a Disney backpack on, surrounded by all these people your age who you didn't know and had to make friends with all at once. It was probably pretty scary. But life was also simple back then. As long as you knew your multiplication tables or got to play a game of tag, life would be just fine. Things probably got more complicated as you got older. In middle school and high school, you may have had to deal with bullies or learn how to navigate romantic relationships for the first time. And once you got to college, you had all of that. But now you had to figure out what you were going to do with the rest of your life. How you were going to contribute to society. And many of you probably felt pressure to go into high-intensity industries. And then, when you actually entered the workforce, you realized that not only could life be complicated, but also cold. You realized you had to play office politics, and that sometimes numbers ruled all. And many of us became cynical. Now here we are at the end of Wharton, and there's no doubt that cynicism is still on the menu. COVID certainly didn't help things, but we also have classes such as Influence, which teach us how to be a professional Slytherin. By the way, let's be honest. Since we go to Wharton, most people already think that we are all Slytherins. But a funny thing has happened. I have seen you all go back to the person you were as a child. And I say this as a good thing. Some of you have affectionately referred to Wharton as business camp, where you have discovered and rediscovered passions. Some of you have taken up hockey, falling constantly, but loving every minute of it. Some of you have acted and danced in front of hundreds of people, many for the very first time. Some of you have traveled, falling in love with new countries or people. And some of you have finally had a chance to stop and think on what you are really passionate about and pursue it. Over these 2 years, we have all had a chance to understand who we really are and had a chance to find ourselves. And that is also a cliche. But maybe cliches are just part of being human. So, as you all find yourself on the precipice of returning back to the business world, don't forget about that person you were as a child. Bring those passions that you found here at Wharton with you, and remember, it's okay to be a little cliche. Thank you, everyone. It's been an awesome 2 years with you all. And now it is my true and utmost pleasure to introduce the Vice Dean of the MBA program, Howard Corfold. Since many of us took his corporate finance class, we know him as Professor Howie, but all of us know him as Dean Howie. I have personally always appreciated Dean Howie's willingness to sit down and have a chat throughout the year, and I hope he enjoys his retirement to the simple teaching life. Howie, on behalf of the class of 2022, I would like to recognize and thank you for your leadership and dedication to building and strengthening the MBA student experience, not only during our 2 years here at Wharton, but also for the thousands of MBA alumni who have graduated during your time leading the best MBA program in the world. Let's give it up for Dean Howie.
Thank you, Philip. Thank you very much. Greetings, members of the MBA class of 2022, fellow faculty and colleagues, and a warm welcome to partners, family members, and friends. Today we come together to applaud your outstanding achievements, as we've said, inside and outside the classroom. And these accomplishments are even more remarkable given the challenging environment you weathered while pursuing your MBA. The last time we were all together as a class, or I should say Zooming together, was in August 2020, almost 2 years ago. Although given how our lives have been changed by COVID since then, it seems a lifetime ago. On your first day as Wharton students, the MBA staff and I had to welcome you virtually, even though most of you were just blocks away from campus. It was the beginning of a surreal 2 years for students and staff alike, where we all had to do things very differently. As a first year, you had to adapt to virtual classrooms and learn to figure out new ways to get to know classmates and faculty, overcoming physical limitations, changing COVID metrics, and not knowing when things would return to normal. When you returned to school for year two, you were faced with a different situation, with the advent of vaccinations, universal masking, and new safety protocols. We all ventured tentatively back into the classroom as Wharton began to rebuild the learning environment for a COVID world. But it was the initiative of student leaders that was essential to connecting classmates into a reconfigured community. Those of you who served as leadership and student life fellows, you stepped up to lead preterm, having never experienced this orientation in person yourselves, since, of course, your preterm was virtual. You revived hallmark student gatherings in person, such as Pub, Folly, Storytellers, Dance Studio, the Women in Business Summit, and the Whitney Young Conference. You embraced the return of class-wide celebrations, but also organized smaller group interactions and learned JOMO, the joy of missing out. You made sure that there were options for classmates to participate virtually because of health or other concerns about attending events in person. You committed to advancing diversity at Wharton as the African American, Asian American, and Hispanic American MBA associations held a first ever joint forum to share challenges and goals, thereby increasing the likelihood of mutual progress. You also established a safe environment for students to learn how to have conversations on sensitive topics such as race, gender, class, disability, and sexuality. And these Real Talk sessions also provided the administration with additional building blocks to educate future generations of Wharton MBAs. These are just a few examples of how your resilience and determination in the face of unanticipated obstacles carried you through to the finish line today. While I know that the losses, disruptions, and setbacks that you faced were at times overwhelming, I'm confident that you'll look back on this period as one of great personal growth and strength, albeit honed by adversity. Now, fortified with the Wharton MBA, you are well equipped as problem solvers, innovators, and leaders to re-enter a work world that has changed irrevocably in many ways. Throughout these two uncertain years, you have encouraged each other and have been championed by partners, family, friends, and faculty. I'd like us to please pause, please give a round of applause to all of those people who have supported you through your 2 years. While support from your classmates helped you navigate the challenges the past 2 years, I too have been sustained by the people around me. I'm grateful to the senior leadership team, Mary Ellen Riley, Stefan Diekman, Suzanne Kaufman-DePoit, Jeff Klein, and Antoinette McDermott for their creativity, resilience, humor, and unwavering commitment to upholding the excellence of the Wharton MBA experience. I've been privileged to work with them to lead the best MBA program in the world. We at Wharton have been greatly enriched by your presence and are grateful for the many ways that you have contributed to the intellect, the character, and the heart of our program. My colleagues join me in wishing you our very best for your next chapter. Congratulations. It is now my great pleasure to announce the Palmer Scholars for the class of 2022. These students consistently performed at the highest level with an academic performance that placed them in the top 5% of the class. Join me in congratulating these students on their outstanding achievement. I would ask each of the scholars to rise and remain standing when I call their names. Michael Adams. Paige Diane Bellissimo. Jordan Bonneville. Ryan Brown. Edward Joseph Butler III. Alexander Carbone. Ming William Chen. Siyu Chen. Adam Cohen. Carly Christ. Anumita Das. Ryan Franco. Brian Philip Fulginiti. Brendan Gallagher. Ho Kyung Brian Go. Megan Gonzalez. Drew Guerra. Maguire Harriman. Ross Hawkwart. Matthias Kibikas. Sophia Kim. Elizabeth Kennard. Belin Lee. David Liu. Michal Lobash. Thomas Masters. Elana Mir. Peggy Moriarty. Patrick Nikon. Nicholas Picone. Vicky Plestis. Jason Pop. Thomas James Radigan. Gonzalo Ramos. Ritik Rao. Maxwell Andrew Rigby. Sonia Robiner. Michael Russell. Alexander Saccone. Kevin Sand. Bridget Scanlon. Samantha Schiff. Ankur Shah. Ross Shahinian. Colin Shaw. Daniel Sheehan. Kevin Williams Sampson. Michal Sobirajski. Nacha Sutirasan. Timo Vaiman. Taylor Valentine. Colin Wang. Stuart Whiteford. Yankun Wu. And Khadija Zaman. Congratulations to our Palmer Scholars of the Class of 2022. Each year, academic departments, be seated, but I'm going to ask you to stand again in a second. Thank you. Each year, academic departments and the second year class recognize students who have excelled in the classroom and those who have made an impact on the community during their 2 years at Wharton. I call your attention now to the screens above as we honor the recipients of these awards for the class of 2022. Thank you. Our student award winners, please stand so that we can recognize you for these accomplishments, please. And also, I'd ask our Palmer Scholars to rise once more so that we can recognize all of you. Congratulations, Class of 22 Student Award winners and Palmer Scholars. Thank you. Congratulations. Now, as we begin the roll call, just a quick reminder. Remember about those three options that you have to greet Dean James? Elbow bump, namaste, and the Wakanda greeting. After you greet Dean James, I have the honor of presenting you with your ceremonial diploma. Again, please, no handshakes. Okay, are you ready? Okay, dear MBA class of 2022, the time has come for you to be recognized as graduates of the oldest and best business school in the world.
Michelle Arifin. Gautam Shukani. Isabella Espinel Marsano. Andrew Hosbein. Philip Ross. Carolina Beltran Weber. Robert Joseph Harrison V. Olivia Evans. Avi Ahuja. Brent Allen. Joshua Auerbach. Alijan Aichichek. Lucas Burke. Alexander Beschloss. Adam Breslin. Alec Bronder. Zorbe Jean Turk. Jorge Cardenas. Adriana Castillo Fisher. Inge Chen. Siyu Chen. Laura Claggett. Sergio Andres Clara. Richbergen de Roche. Isa Tu Dion. Fungman Chi. Tianjiao Gao. Runark Dar. Hagar Goma. Alexandra Griswold. Carl Grosselin. Jody Davina Ha. Shane Hong. Kewe DeWeet. Drew Ives. Chelsea Jackson. Shreya Jaggi. James Jameson. Michael Janes. Zachary Johnson. Ryan Canali. Nikhil Karnik. Matthias Kabikas. David Klippel. Chloe Lansdale. Nicole Lee. Brian Leong. Irene Leo. Evan Ivy Leo. Parker Lowe. Evelyn Lupimo. Robert James McGregor. Tiffany Monte Seaway. Peggy Mugiarty. Kenan Murphy Sierra. Michael Nelson. Dimitri Nicolaou. Lily O'Connell. Ward Odenwald IV. Graham Palmer. John Peng. Thomas John Pesch. Jason Pop. Alex Chapelsky. Rodrigo Ruiz Huidobro Gonzalez. Jahan Seb Shahid. Harshid Sohu. Mumodu Lamin Sonku. Claire Elizabeth Grief. Carter Stevens. Nuchar Sutirasarn. Olivia Ott. Nicholas Van Holen. Avery Wendell. Jingying Xu. Xu Qing. Anthony Strong. Yuande Alade. Nicholas Allen. Tanya Amberiadis. Dementra Angelakis. Richard Antwi Boasikao. Timothy Baker. Paige Diane Bellissimo. Akwasi Brefo. Edward Joseph Butler III. Nathan Case. Wei Cheng. Yun Chu. Yash Chopra. Gregory Clement. Patrick Collins. Gabriel David. Daniel Dawson. Vanessa December. John Domino. Brian Doney. Ryan Patrick Finley. Alyssa France. Naya Fraser. Jim Yanakopoulos. Lauren Gilbert. Isabel Grenan Field. Kyle Hairston. Alexandra Harenberg. Zachary Thompson. Joshua Goldberg. Ikram Hawk. Walter Honeywell. Anthony Hurtado. Kelsey Jacobson. Sarah Jane. Peter Kapoutsos. Shreyas Kataria. Paul Kim. Jared Libos. Christine Lettingham. Menghao Li. Charles Leo. Thomas Masters. Priyanka Ravindra Milgiri. Zachary Miles. Ken Omar Min. Joseph Murard. Eric Myers. Karna Nangia. Asleen Shelby Nelson. Nathaniel Nunez. Frank Midega Odero. Patrick Premel. Ritik Rao. Vidya Sekaran. Sarah Ufsal Shamsi. Himanshu Sharma. Genevieve Shaw. Patrick Allen Shikani. Anirudh Singh. Ryan Smith. Corey Spees. Kevin Stang Jr. Ariel Stern. Saron Tekiye. Sam Thomas. Neil Wally. David Wong. Elliot Jarrett Watts. Wu Wei Chiwon Winston. Patrick Wilkie. Yangkun Wu. Felicia Yu. Hilary Lesham. Anyebiet Abbasi. Adam Abriam. Ola Tilewa Uluwara Miola Zabdil Adutulo. Karthik Aragam. Caio Azevedo. Jennifer Biondo. Jane Elizabeth Black. Sheer Boguer. Clark Brown Jr. Helen Chen. Gregorio Concha Toro. Xiu Dong. Brendan Dupner. Michal Edelman. Brendan Ferisic. Gibson Farone Collins. Christopher Farrow. Chris Ferrer. Isabel Rose Weiss Friedman. Kish Green. Grant Griffith. Tanya Gupta. Zachary Hubert. Nora Jendubi. Anisha Kamat. Christine Kanoff. Matthew Kim. Daniel Kronz. Nevin Kulangara. Julia Medri. Justin McAuliffe. Felipe Mila Santos. Shivina Mittal. Michelle Mokes. Benjamin Murdoch. Keegan Ken Eng. Ling Nguyen. Matthew O'Donohue. Kohei Okamura. Satoshi Ozawa. Pallavi Bala Rajaram. Franz Rasmussen. Alicia Rege. Matthew Riley. Sherard Roberts. Catherine Rolfe. Colin Shaw. Charles Henry Sherman. Viman Singh. Meredith Slott. Mapari Sotude. Bon Nichapat Siwanawat. Sruti Tadipali. Amanda Terrill. Vikram Ver Thakur. Vanessa Toppler Garcia. Anthony Trupidoro. Natasha Vaz. Jesse Weinberg. Courtney Wong. Sean Chiu. Emily Ruche Jang. Emily Hanji Zhang. Cindy Siong Zhao.
Matthew Gallup. Anne Fisher. Mohammed Albaiti. Emily Albert. Jonathan Bartolome Arseno. Alakea Adi. Anjali Batla. Gregory Bostick. Christian Boulanger. Evan Bravender. Gabriella Ariana Campaverde. Rani Choi. Carly Christ. Lakshmi Davi. Sean Dai. Juliana Escobar Pena. Rebecca Lee Feldman. David Thomas Fisher. Elena Fomini. Luke Fraker. Maxwell Freesha. Mark Anthony Fuchs Jr. Brendan Gallagher. Megan Garg. Andrew James Jeenan. Anu Gupta. Sydney Harrison. Philip Hilaire. Ian Hosang. Alexander Su. Yifan Huang. Shruti Kela. Andrew Lee. Malcolm Leverett. Bilin Lee. Nicole Linderman. David Lowe. Andrea Madu. Kyle McCormick. Corey McCumber. Kristen Meredith, sorry. Emmeline Milbank. Andre Jake Mota. Elsa Mao. Namrata Nevada. Carolyn Nelson. Kelechi Odocha. Annika Pandey. Jack Reed. Samir Rustagi. Alan Shi. Andrew Shi. Priyanka Shom. Kevin William Simpson. Marvin So. Philip Song. Michael Sorrentino. Alex Spiegel. Joseph Strage. Ziwei Tong. Liren Trong. Sarah Turpin. Ngozi Nineya Uday. Channing Alexander Weir. Colin Wright. Yuchen Christina Ye. Max Yelski. Claire Yi. Daniel Zhu. Ming William Chen. Ashley Augustin. Cherise Baker. Andrea Botero Arizabal. Tina Branham. Jing Chai. Yen Yu Chang. Mark Choi. Stacy Anna Delapena. Susan Dong. Natalia Duarte. Sanji Dutta. Florencia Falk. David Farahi. David Faust. Alexander Faraz. Juan Jiho. Alexandra Gray. Drew Guerra. Vidur Kumar Gupta. David Hafford. Adam Harrell. Paige Heller. Zachary Hickey. Raul Call. Maha Akhtar Khan. Madeline Kipp. Elizabeth Knarr. Charlie Kolasek. Arjun Krishna. Ethan Landau. Joseph Lanzilla. Mackenzie Laudell. Jung Lee. Xingtong Lee. Molly Lowry. Mitchell Lubas. Shalini Mumjumdar. William McKinney. Brian McMahon. Daniel Miao. Xi'an Mo. Kavya Nagala. Kevin Nam. Alf Nikolai Nielsen. Patrick Nikong. Tejas Pachak. Nicholas Picone. Jessica Powers. Michael Ravitsky. Mitch Reeves. Callie Reynolds. Alexa Rogers. Thomas Rockholt. Danielle Rosen Tomasi. Elizabeth Ross. Maggie Selvin. Kayo Shinobare. Nathan Paul Sofio Jr. Francisco Vargas. Colin Wong. Genevieve Weichert. Jeffrey Wilson. Jessica Hsu. Samuel Yang. Shuyi Yang. Jack Zhang. Adit Patel. Hirsch Agarwal. Badr Alad, Elena Atala Yunus. Jesse Bandeen. Matthew Berland. Ashley Betts. Brian Caronia. Ranjana Chandramouli. Justin Chapman. Ping Chin. Brian Dasrath. Joseph Decker. Isabel Dolgen. Christmas Abawale. Ross Emery. Daniel Ensign. Safir Tuna Esmail. Fame Hamza. Yuan Fan. Anne Fountain. Jalen Gilmore. William Brendan Hanowski. Ha Jia. John Hilferty. Matthew Hirsch. Martin Hood. Ed Hunter. Sabrina Natasha Jean-Baptiste. Christopher Johnson. Claire King. Jack Kleinman. Nanthini Kumararajan. Elena Leone. Tony Lin. Daniel Marquardt. Elizabeth Martin. Jonathan Mest. Scott Christopher Moore. Shinya Morimoto. Arjun Nukal. Siddharth Patel. John Alexander Pepinjak. Anshul Romani, Megan Tyler Reed, Ingrid Caroline Rowers, Kevin Sand, Ben Sadaloff, Brioni Schultz, Emily Schreck, Brian Scott, Sanjana Shaw, Ross Shahinian, Derek Shillman, Tara Marie Sullivan, Catherine Rin Tin Tang, James Ulrich, Taylor Valentine, Kyle Visser, Philip Wagley, Cliff Wong, Todd Andrew Wersch, Justin Wong, Stephen Wu, Amy Shu, Tina Shu, Joe Shu, Srujana Yadlapali, Hanson Yang, Jason Yu, Nancy Zhang, Sherry Zhang,
Kristen Kellum Myers, Rukmini Mahukar, Jeremy Adam, Jukta Basu Malik, Alexander Bernhardt, Varun Bave, Wilson Perry Brace, Perrin Tyler Bulakul, Vicky Chen, Nigel Quello, Joshua Kogan, Ryan Davidson, Charles DeCavallo, Rebecca De La Espriella, Alexander Dixon, Brittany Drangler, Maham Ijaz, Shayna Fader, Xiaoyu Feng, John Taylor Garner, Gaurav Gidwani, Emily Gisolfi, Stephanie Hennings, Ross Hawkward, Mackenzie Hume, Thomas Clark Irvin. Mackenzie Johnston. Kyle Jorgensen. Nanny Kim. Tal Krause. Hanjay Lee. Robert Lee. Brexton Lethco. Melissa Levy. Milton Lewis. Butian Lee. Johnson Bentley James Lightfoot. Yi Liu. Shane Maloney. Dylan McGolin. James Marvel. Jamie Marvel. Ali Ray McCloskey. Connor Daniel McKenna. John Thomas Milton the Seventh. Kushal Mepori. Maria Aspasia Nikopoulos. Sandra Nemaka Nwusu. Victoria Lynn Osborne. Mina Owari. Nick Petruzzi. Anna Marie Perk. Camila Rachmanis. Thomas James Radigan. Daisy Michelle Rincon. Sonia Robinar. Simo Mohamed Semhaji Razi. John Mu So. Tom Shaw. Mansook Singh. Priyanka Singh. Brian John Smith. Andrew Sparks. Joshua Stoffer. Kirthana Sundar. Puneet Tiaru. Jack Trunzo. Detlef von Zerwalt. Bainey Wong. Jehan Saip. Alisa Kosti. Pianpian Adelson. Serena Advani. Brian Alter. Joyce Yu Juhung Bei. Lee Andrew Barnes III. Vera Barnwell. Pei Lu Chen. Pierce Chilton. Sarah Chung. Adam Cohen. Kevin DeBurk Daly. Juliet Del Rosario. Jonathan Diakonwa. Brian Dinner. Beshmir Dishnatsa. Kevin Dong. Diego Sola. Kenyatta Sasha Duncan. Tola Emiola. Patrick Annis. Bryson Bono. Poo Kyung Brian Go. Rodrigo Gonzalez Castellanos. Sarah Han. Christopher Harvey. Andrea Alessandra Herrera Santiago. Jordan Hill. Bill Houston. Garrett Howard. Sakshi Jain. Danielle Jellerette. Garrett Johnson. Ryan Johnson. Alexandra Yonker. Elena Joyner. Samuel Carlin. Sophia Kim. Joshua Kleiman. Laura Knabel. William Lee. Alan Levitas. Susan Lee. Jingyi Leo. Daniela Lomo. Mackenzie Lucas. Alessandro Mengi. Jessica Moore. George Naughton. Joseph Nelson. JP Ortiz. Arun Palmer. Lucas Andreas Peterson. Timothy Kramer Qualls Jr. Mosa Rahimi. Neha Reddy. Allison Rose. Ankur Shah. James Schechter. Daniel Shihom. Wenhua Whitney Sheng. Jasmine Slaughter. Jacob Schwartz. Jared Tagan. Victoria Estelle Thompson. Catherine Tumera. Kevin Trainer. Timo Weyman. Christina Lee Wang. Ding Wong. Abigail Wang. Amy Young. Taylor Weissmuller. Joseph Shang.
Lauren Paige Aiken. Isabella Amorim Gonzalez. Isaac Beck. William Bonnell. Wailhu Ajram. Blair Boyce. Alexander Carbone. Michael Chambas. Christine Chen. Sagar Chopra. Kimberly Cohen. Singleton Crawford. Michael DePerson. Mariam Dembele. Caroline Cassidy Dickey. Carla Dominonche Canals. Erna Feifei. Clifford Foreman. Cedric Fujai Petnew. Taylor Golding. Bree Groh. Harrison Han. Chi Han. Kevin William Harvey. Maguire Harriman.
Jonathan Huang. Hangjun Her. Jia Zhang. Lindsay Elizabeth Kelt. Sam Lai. Niklas Barrett Larson. Stephen May. Matt Londa. Zachary March. Heather Meets. Gonzalo Morel Ruiz. Sam Mulholland. Nivi Nagaraj. Alan Noir. Mera Patel. Hannah Plon. David Rubin. Kanupriya Samarendra. Caitlin Sanders. Bridget Scanlon. Maggie Shell. Natalie Sheng. Eric Cheruz. Lucas Sullivan. Heiji Song. David Tauber. Thibaut Tyrion. Melissa Tobin. Boompavat Yumanarudmit. Vimal Vadera. Ranjit Vadlamanati. Anjali Wadwa. Suni Wang. Benjamin Weaver. Alec Rubel. Jennifer Zhu. Eric Yang. Yi Yang. Andrew Yates. Jinlin Ye. Zach Zabashnik. Caroline Zhang. Gloria Zhang. Niklas Zhao. Xufeng Zhao.
Iris Shao. Alicia Ann May. Clement Adewuye. Mariam Amirakanashvili. Christina Anderson. Jordan Isoff. Orlande Pupo Ayola. Eric Berg. Chayate Berlgen. Swati Bhatia. Jordan Bonneville. Christopher Caggiano. Ashish Chalasani. Anusha Chivakula. Courtney Clower. Abdul Rahman Dadaboy. John Dennison. Yana Ernesarova. Yilet Fernandez. Brian Philip Fulginetti. Gopal Galgalia. Javier Gonzalez. James Goyer. Jason Green. Marc-Antoine Grandin. Ling Haan. Moon Hu. Philip Hayward. Brooke Ashley Hill. James Trent Holbrook Jr. Justin Jinsen. Sangwoo Jin. Leah Jones. David Kornberg. Katie Lee. Peter Lavolsi. Kevin Lowe. Audley Maurice Mackle IV. Aditya Majumdar. Christina Mani. Francisco Mato. Catherine McDowell. Henry Meyerson. Dennis Gilbert Morrill Jr. Roger Nawukuliyo. Thomas Obermeyer. Tom Orlander. Morgan Pearson. Johanna Peppa. Vicky Plestis. Kay Pradhan. Gonzalo Ramos. Maria Rincon. Divya Sushadri. Rosh Menenko. Shreya Sitaraman. Harrison Slutsky. Hannah Smith. Tiffany Song. Sudipta Sridhara. Natalie Stachapanyak. Rashad Tajiev. Diana Tian. Peter Edward Christopher Vale. Samad Wahid. Ayanna Warrington. Matthew Weinseer. Elise Camille Sargent Wilkinson. Maria Shing. Khadija Zaman. Caroline Zhu. Tori Zhuang. Priya Krishnan. Agniola Uhananminu. Kevin Stewart Anthony. Manuel Arbiola. Jacqueline Marie Barr. Brian Bartlett. Andrew Bruce Beckevold. Igor Bentes. Saruj Bhatt. John Bogle. Stephanie Bonk. Ryan Brown. Linda Chang. William Corbett. Allison Courtney. Stephanie Curtis. Ituna Deborah DaCosta. Serene Majdi Darwish. Ryan Dayton. Felix Duan. Roshan Dutha. Ryan Frankel. Dunajay Goyle. Nazario Gonzalez Garza. Carolina Gonzalez. Megan Gonzalez. Jenna Ching Huang. Henry Downs Jameson V. Connie Zhao. Himsa Jivani. Soumya Suresh Chandra Karki. Harneet Kaur. Minju Kim. Sunghoon Kim. Akshay Keeney. Chris Kwok. Alexandra Laval. Harry Lesher. Kelsey Latang. Gabriella DiCastro Marini. Christiani Miller. Madeline Molo. Laura Lenore Munoz. Brooke Nelson. Thomas O'Duden. E.K. Obi Okonkwo. Sushi Radhakrishnan. Lonnie Reed. Nini Wren. Nicholas Reynard. Logan Richard. Alexander Saccone. Natasha Joy Sacrini. Larissa Sanchez Dominguez. Elizabeth Sarachev. Joshua Schwalison. Samantha Schiff. Deborah Schweitzer Dari. Ravina Singh. Jeremy Staffman. Alex Sun. Brian Tisdale. Anshal Vig. Mariah Villasenor. Mark Ward. Stuart Whiteford. Nicholas Williams. Jordan Woodard. Kevin Wan Zhang. Frankie Lam. Antonio Abreu. Michael Adams. Nirma Amakrakun. Sengud Badamsed. Kevin Blanian. Salvador Carbo. Nicole Carpenter. Andrew Shampo. Jessica Chen. Bonita Siyue Chen. Kathleen Cordray. Jason D. Rose. Lillian Angela Dow. Anumita Das. Carly Delahose. Beatriz Zielishinsky. Michael Fee. Juan Pablo Fernandez Narduia. Connor Fox. Emily Fritke. Stephen Gurney Goldman. Vahid Hochmund. Jack Wong. Tyler Hunter. Joshua Kamali. Alexander Cornick. Miguel Lacayo. Lisa Lee. David Liu. Alexander McKenzie. Eric Mangone. Marco Marni. Rashid Mohan. Kwesi Morgan Arhan. Andrew Mack. Allison Morrison. Megan Murphy. Satoshi Nakamura. Hugh Nguyen. Patrick Nugent. Lisbeth Nunez. Chukwuka Ofili. Susie Pan. Ramasathwik Pathareddy. Melvin Santiago Pena. Jenny Chen. Eric Revich. Maxwell Andrew Rigby. Maria Juliana Rivera Aldana. William Roberts. Taylor Rose. Julia Ryu. Max Siegel. Frederico Segura. Cody Shang. Mihao Subureski. Joseph Blake Sullivan. William Tarnell. Kai Zin Thet. Julia Uribe. Uyen Vo. Sophie White. Arthur White. Claire Wiley. Joanne Wu. Julie Hyun Su. Joel Yadidian. Amanda Young. Daniel Yu. Wendy Yu. Cindy Zhang. And finally, Basil Emmond Zikri.
Almost finished. You've been a very patient group. Thank you for your attention and honoring all of our graduates. Congratulations on your graduation. Welcome to the Wharton MBA alumni community. To commemorate the occasion, please move your tassels from right to left. My name is Sam Lundquist. I'm Wharton's Chief Advancement Officer in the Office of External Affairs. And just as you were supported throughout your MBA experience by a dedicated team in the Graduate Division, please know that there is a team of alumni relations staff and volunteers who will care for you going forward. It's a labor of love for us, and we look forward to working with you and seeing you throughout your careers. Wharton is strong because of its alumni community. You are now members of an alumni community of more than 100,000 living graduates from a remarkable 153 countries around the world. Do you remember how proud you felt the day you were admitted to Wharton? That was an important moment and a turning point in all of your lives, but it was just the beginning of your relationship with the school. You will carry Wharton for the rest of your lives. It's now part of your personal brand. Your Wharton education will contribute to your success going forward, and your success will lift and strengthen Wharton at the same time. In the end, we need you, and we will always be here for you. In fact, wherever you go in the world, we will be there for you. Our network is truly global. We will make sure that you have plenty of opportunities to grow in your career, sharpen your skills, and expand your perspective on business. In fact, in listening to Alex Gorsky's remarks today, I'm reminded that even though you've just graduated from Wharton, you have not taken your last Wharton class. We have a robust lifelong learning program that will provide relevant and convenient contact and content for you throughout your life. So take advantage of these opportunities. Remain involved at the school and the remarkable alumni network. We just had a reunion weekend. I'm sure you noticed it over the past couple of days. And I've spoken to so many alumni who have acknowledged the role that Wharton has played in their success. And it's directly tied to the success that they've had in their careers. With gratitude, they choose to give back to the school and pay it forward to future generations. As you step into life as alumni, your participation in the 2022 last gift deepens your relationship with the school. Thank you for those who gave in investing in the future of the Wharton School. We're grateful for your dedication to Wharton and the contributions of the class gift. Your class achieved 50% participation and raised $57,000. We thank this year's alumni fellows who worked tirelessly to ensure the success of the class gift campaign. Now I'd like to welcome Gautam Chokhanzi, alumni fellow co-chair and vice president of alumni affairs for Wharton Graduate Association, who will now present the check to Dean James. I'm now delighted to share with you a special Wharton tradition. Each year, alumni who have demonstrated leadership within the Wharton and Penn community are extended an invitation to participate in commencement. One graduate is selected to serve as alumni marshal who will pass the 2022 alumni flag to a member of the graduating class. This year, we're thrilled to have Bonnie Miao Bandine, a Wharton parent, a 1980 college graduate, a 1985 Wharton MBA graduate, as our alumni marshal this year. Bonnie is a Penn trustee, a member of the Wharton Board of Advisors, a recipient of Wharton's Distinguished Service Award, among many other involvements at the school. We are deeply grateful for her commitment, leadership, and meaningful support to the Wharton School and the Penn community. In passing the 2022 alumni flag to Michelle Arifrin, Bonnie is linking Wharton alumni from previous years to those today. Congratulations. Welcome to the Wharton alumni community. Congratulations.
Thank you, Sam and Bonnie, and thanks to all of our 100,000 alumni around the globe who make Wharton's community the largest, most impactful, and most engaging alumni community in the world. You are now not only a part of Wharton's alumni community, but you are also a part of the Penn alumni community, where you will continue to grow and nurture the personal, intellectual, and professional relationships you've made during your time here at the University of Pennsylvania. And I hope to see you at commencement on Monday. As we close out today's ceremony, it remains my hope that each and every graduate understands how much this community is proud of you and excited for you. May your Wharton experience serve you well in your future endeavors. And now, the moment you've been waiting for. Graduates, grab those caps. Congratulations!